the fall of 2010, I began a new project in which I needed tide data, and I needed old tide data. So I started finding out that there was a lot of 20th century data missing, and then I found hints of an even earlier generation of data. Finally, I was able to communicate to NOAA, and they said, oh yeah, here we have this wall full of binders. And while I was flipping the pages, I found the keys to the treasure chest. And that was a series of 26 boxes. It contained all the long-term tide data that has been collected in the U.S. since 1844. And it turned out that those 26 boxes, minus a few that are missing, unfortunately, are now in the National Archives. I sent a student to the National Archives, and he took thousands of pictures, and we obtained many, many years of data to create almost a nearly continuous data set that more or less doubles the length of the tide record in New York. In the early days of the New York tide record, and in fact all the old tide records before about 1850 or 1853 on the East Coast, there was an actual observer who would go out during high water or low water and would measure what the level of the tide was relative to a tide staff. And in 1852, something new happened, and that was the invention of a automatic tide gauge. And so the way this tide gauge worked was that it first started with a stilling well. Then on top of this water in the stilling well, in this pipe, you have a float. And the float goes up and down, and the float is connected to a chain. And the chain is connected to a pencil, and the pencil moves up and down on a piece of paper. The scroll of paper wasn't stationary, but in fact was being moved forward by a clock mechanism. And so as the paper moved, you get a continuous trace of the tide that has been reduced by a scale of 12 to 1 or 14 to 1 or 10 to 1. And these are the scrolls that now exist. Many of them still exist in the National Archives. It is as if we had a time-lapse or a time-lapse camera, you could think. If you just had a camera on a street corner somewhere, say New York, and you took a picture every hour for the last 150 years, you would be able to infer quite a bit of what has happened and what has changed. For me, it has been really neat to look at some of the old records and to hold things from a long gone age in my hands.